Hi guys, welcome back to Relax My Cat. It's Claire and Rags, and today I'm going to be showing you some basic grooming for your cat. Whether your cat has long hair or short hair or even no hair, it is a good idea to get into the habit of grooming your cat on a regular basis. So maybe like once or twice a week, just to make sure that their coat is kept in a pristine condition, and not only is it healthy and shiny, but it's free from knots, bacteria, muck, all that kind of thing. So Rexy and I are going to show you some basics. First of all, you need a cat, and next you need some basic tools. A fine tooth comb, which is good not only for checking for fleas, but also to tease out any knots. A basic brush. And if you have a longer haired cat, you can actually get something called a furminator, which is really good at taking off the layer of fur that's come loose and making sure they're nice and shiny. Now, it's important to know how to groom your cat. I know it sounds really obvious, but when you are brushing your cat, make sure that you are brushing the same way that the fur grows, like this. Cats absolutely hate to get their fur pushed the wrong way. It's very uncomfortable for them, and Ragsy particularly absolutely hates it. So when you're grooming your cats, just make sure you're going the same way that the fur is growing. Now, it's a good idea to groom your cat like this once or twice a week, just to keep their coat in its best condition. Now, if your cat gets any knots or mats, getting a teasing comb is a really good idea. Now, Ragsy gets quite a few knots around sort of her back end here and in between her legs. So if you find any on cat, get a teasing comb and just isolate the knot. Now just isolate the knot and just tease it gently. Now cats have very sensitive skin, so you need to be careful when you're teasing. They might not enjoy you doing it, but it's better than snipping them out, which will leave them a little bald spots. And there we have our little knot. Now these little brushes are also good for checking for fleas. So if you notice any little bugs or little black spots or little black dust on your cat, just go through their fur and check them out. If you do find little black spots or some little insects, it's time to treat your cat for fleas. Now another thing to get into the habit of doing is trimming your cat's nails. Now not all cats will let you trim their nails, and Ragsy is one of those. So I actually get her nails trimmed at the vet's. You can get these nail trimmers from good pet shops and even at your vet's. So it's a good idea if your cat will let you to get a good pair of nail clippers. These are designed specifically for cats' nails. Don't use human ones because they might hurt them. Now, another good habit to get into is checking your cat's ears on a regular basis. They are quite prone to getting muck in them and to get infections and sometimes even mites. So when you have your cat down, be very, very careful. They do have sensitive ears, and you just check them for extra wax, any sort of gunge or build up, or any sort of mites or anything. You're good. Just do that once a week just to make sure that your cat's ears are nice and clean and healthy. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you did enjoy this video. If you did, please give us a big thumbs up. It helps out the channel loads. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel already, just hit that button in the middle there. And while you're at it, head on over to the other side of the screen and go give our vlog from last week a bit of love as well. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you did enjoy it, and Ragsy and I will see you in our next video.